Hello and welcome back. In the previous lecture, we've created this nice looking user interface for our app thanks to the Ionic CSS components, and in particular using the list component. In this lecture, we want to improve things a bit further by showing for each story how long ago it was submitted. So next to the domain, we want to show a bit of text saying something like 5 minutes ago or 2 hours ago. Now to do that, first of all, we need the piece of information that tells us when the story was submitted. And luckily we do get that information from the JSON we get from reddit.com. There's a field called created_UTC, which is a timestamp, but it's a Unix timestamp. So as you can see, it's not the sort of thing you want to display to your end users. It is in fact the number of seconds since the 1st of January 1970. So we need some way to convert this raw timestamp to something more user-friendly. And luckily, there's a very popular JavaScript library called Moment.js that does exactly that. If we go to the website, you can see that it's a library to parse, validate, manipulate, and display dates in JavaScript, and it supports features like relative time, which is exactly what we want, things like 18 hours ago or an hour ago. However, since we're using AngularJS, it would be nice if we could find an Angular module that wraps this library in a convenient way. So let's see if there is something like that. Let's search for Moment.js Angular. And we can find exactly such a project. Angular Moment, Moment.js directives for AngularJS. So this looks promising. Let's check that it does indeed what we want. What we're interested in is this time ago directive. So this should allow us to pretty much copy and paste this example. And thanks to this custom directive, it should format our timestamp the way we want. That is showing something like a few seconds ago or a minute ago. So that's all very well, but how do we import this project into our own project? We could manually download the JavaScript file and copy it into our www folder. However, we don't just need Angular Moment, we also need Moment.js, so we will need to go and download that one as well. And there's a better way to do this, and that is using a package manager. If you look at the first suggested installation method, that's using Bower. If you haven't heard of Bower, that's a package manager for the web. That is, it's similar to npm, the tool that we used to install the Ionic command line interface, for example. But it is used for web dependencies, that is, library that we want to include in our application, as opposed to tools and packages that we use on the command line, like for the npm packages that we've installed so far. So the project, as created by the Ionic start command, already has support for Bower, so we can use this. So let's go and see how this works. Let me quit the Ionic serve process. And first of all, you do need to have Bower already installed. If you don't, you can install it using npm. You can do npm install -g Bower. But I've done this already, so I can just copy and paste this example here. So we can do Bower install angular moment --save. And the good thing about package managers is that it doesn't just download angular moment, but as you can see, it also downloaded moment.js. Now let's see what else we need to do. Well, we need to import these scripts into our HTML, of course. So let's do that. Let's put these after Ionic and indent this properly. And you can notice that these components are actually under lib. You can see that now we have not just Ionic, but also this Angular Moment that contains angularmoment.js. And we have Moment that contains moment.js. So we need to replace components with lib. The next step is adding Angular Moment as an Angular dependency to our module. So in our JavaScript file, we have our module called myReddit that depends on Ionic, and it now depends on Angular Moment as well. And finally, we should be able to use this directive. And we want the second example because we have a Unix timestamp. So this is the one that we want. So let's try and copy this into our HTML. So rather than just displaying story created, we can use this bit of HTML and replace message.time with our story.createdUTC. And we can see if that works or not. So let me show the app again first, and then I can also remove this bit and finally save. And you can see that we get 2 minutes ago for the first story, and then if we scroll down, we get an hour ago, 2 hours ago, and so on. So that's all working fine. And this is the end of the lecture. We've seen how to add a third-party JavaScript library using Bower to our project, and we've improved our user interface by showing how long ago each story was submitted. In the next lecture, we'll see another couple of very cool features provided by Ionic, and that is pull to refresh and infinite scroll. See you later.